The Cirrus application is a great example of how graphical system design certainly empowers project managers like Andre, but the tools provided give these architects like Mark reliable and control tools to do that. Now, renewable energy technologies like we saw with solar, they certainly are in their early stages as compared to traditional power generation. And as these technologies mature, we're seeing new interesting surrounding challenges arise around them. But that's why we've brought the system designers here on stage today to share how they're looking at solving those problems to make these renewable energies more mainstream. To solve the problem of converting wind into energy, we invented the wind turbine. Now, the challenge with the wind turbine is the optimal location for a wind farm is, of course, in a necessarily turbulent environment. Now, that makes it very dangerous for a technician to perform maintenance on the hardware in the field. Take that complexity and that danger for the technician, you move that wind farm to the middle of an ocean, the scale and the danger of that complexity scales immensely. Imagine trying to board from a boat, get to the wind turbine aboard rough seas. Now, our next guests this morning created a motion compensation gangway system using the graphical system design approach. Please join me in welcoming our very own Dr. Jeannie Falcon of Advanced Control of LabVIEW and Mechatronics, and Dr. Andy Clegg, Controls Consultant and Managing Director of ISC Limited. Thank you. And Dr. Clegg,
Thank you, Shelley. It is indeed a challenging problem, and there are many possible solutions, ranging from using helicopters to simple rope swings. But the most common way of doing this is using a boat, where the boat thrusts at the base of the tower, and then there is a leap of faith from the boat onto the ladder. But rough seas limit when this can be done safely. So our project addresses this by using a hydraulically actuated gangway called the Turbine Access System. Controllers implemented in LabVIEW and Compact Rio automatically compensate for motions of the boat, stabilizing the end of the gangway and so allowing safe transfer between the boat and the tower. At the heart of the system lies the motion reference unit, and this measures the heave, pitch, and roll motions of the boat. These measurements are then passed into the inverse kinematics, which calculate the lengths of the hydraulic cylinders required to achieve stabilization. Cascade control loops coupled with feed-forward and nonlinear compensation ensure that the actual cylinders track the desired very closely and so achieve the required level of stabilization. Operators interact with the system using two touch panel screens, and all of the control and operating logic and monitoring all run on a single Compact Rio.
Thank you, Andy. I think the simulation in this diagram give us a really good of the macro design of the system. But could you speak a little bit about the actual design process for the algorithms for this application?
Yes, certainly. We started with a blank sheet of paper and basically used dynamic simulations to investigate different control strategies and different sensor specifications to prove that the performance required could actually be achieved. And once we had done this, we then took the implementation and implemented the code in LabVIEW using the real-time module, FPGA, and TPC modules. And following that, we then moved to factory testing with the real system. And it was very rewarding to see that the performance obtained during factory testing matched those early simulation results. The photo you can see on the screen there was taken yesterday and shows the system now mounted on the boat. And then the final stage of this is sea trials, which are due to take place when I return back to the UK.
It sounds like I should go with you and try those sea trials.
Well, do you really want to be the first person to walk the turbine access system plank?
Why not?
Well, have you got plenty of seasickness tablets? Unfortunately, we need to have offshore survival training.
All right, maybe next time. Now, you described a lot of different tools that you used to design that algorithm. We talk a lot about the power of the LabVIEW system design software that incorporates many different models of computation, which are simply a fancy word to explain different ways, a natural way to solve your application. Can you tell us about the inverse kinematics algorithm that you used?
Yes, the M-file kinematics code, which was originally developed in MATLAB, was implemented using a MassScript RT node to allow it to run in real time on the Compact Rio.
Wow, Wow, so you used your existing algorithm that you already had, so you were able to reuse that. Was there any issues you had taking your own M file you developed, bringing it into LabVIEW and implementing it on compact Rio hardware?
None at all. It was just a simple cut and paste. And the tight integration between the hardware and software that these tools provides greatly shortens the development process. And in future, we will be planning to use the LabVIEW control design and simulation module in future projects because it contains all of the functionality that we require and also the seamless integration with the hardware that you guys provide.
Right, so the future system will use many models of computation. Now, I know I wasn't the only one excited when I heard about what you and your team have done. I'd like to bring up Dr. Jeannie Falcon, who also wanted to create kind of a mini replica of the system to share with you today.
I was inspired by the turbine access system, a parallel mechanism. So I created a Stuart platform, a parallel
Jeannie,
robot.
I feel like we're going to have another big reveal. I know we had one yesterday, but I can feel it. And I think it's going to be just as exciting. Are you ready for this? Now that, Charles, is marketing.
So we felt really bad for you that you couldn't do the sea trials. So we used a scale model of you, computer engineer Barbie, and we put her on top of the Stuart platform.
Right. Anything we can do to encourage girls in engineering, we'll take it.
So she's on the top, connected via rods to 6 RC servos. That's how we get 6 degrees of freedom. They're controlled with the LabVIEW robotics module. And then I used a mass script node with .mfile syntax running on the real-time compact Rio controller. And that was to compute the inverse kinematics similar to the turbine access system. I'm going to start automated motion of Barbie along each axis, each degree of freedom. So she's moving in heave now, then it'll be surge, sway, roll, pitch, and yaw. And the mass script node in a sub-VI, it takes the commanded motion and it computes the desired motor angles.
Fantastic. Well, Dr. Clegg, maybe you can take Barbie with you on the sea trials.
Will do.
Thank you guys so much for sharing your application.
Thank you.